Oh, hang on. Oh my god, it actually has custom steering wheels! Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good day. Hope you're all having an amazing day today. My name is Lex and welcome back to GTA 5, where right behind me is this beauty. Let's just look at this. Let's just walk up to this thing. It is such a good looking car. It's right now, it just sits so nicely. This is a Dodge Challenger, and the amazing thing about this mod is there is so many tuning options that this could actually become the new best modified car in GTA 5. Before, it was that Mustang that had all the really cool things. You could turn it into the Hoonicorn, all this sort of thing. I reckon this is going to be better than that. I reckon there's going to be so many things to do that this actually might be a very long and jam-packed video full of tuning goodness. So let's just go for a quick drive. Let's just get onto the road here. I've actually started to drive in GTA as if I was driving in real life, with just a slight boost in speed, perhaps, especially on a place like this where we don't really need to worry about people. It's just quite nice to follow the traffic and stuff. So as I drive towards Benny's thing, because yes, you can mod. Okay, sod it. I'm not going to drive properly, because otherwise we're going to be here all day driving across the city. Whoop, excuse me. Yeah, as we drive towards Benny's, yes, this is modifiable in Benny's. This is how good this mod is. We're going to look at some comments and questions from the previous video. If you would like your comments and questions featured, you can leave them in the comment section below, and I'll pick some at random to be featured in the next video. So, I guess I'm going to skip this bit as I'm actually lost right now. I don't normally come into Benny's from this direction, and I don't really know how to get there. So, it's way over this way. I'm nowhere near, actually, at this point. Is anyone else, like, still not used to this map yet and still don't know where they're going? Oh, there it is. There's Benny's. I'm starting to get my bearings. I'm starting to know how to drive in this game, starting to know where things are, but sometimes I do get a little lost. Interested to know how many of you still get lost in this game, or how many of you actually just know your way around now. Be interesting to know. So here we are, coming up to Benny's, and I didn't even use my map. I was pretty proud of that. Right, let's jump in and modify this thing, because there are so many things to check out today. Okay, here we are. Let's just go to repair. And now we have 30 different options inside of here. There are all sorts of things. Armor, brakes, front bumper, rear bumper, exhaust, fender, skirts, roll cage, grill, hood, roof, spoilers, transmission, door speakers, leather seat speakers. Oh god, there's even separate speakers things. Hydraulics, arch covers, window decorations, livery, bodywork, engine, interior, number plate, lights, window tint, turbo, respray, and wheels. So much to do, so much to get on with. Let's get started. Okay, so first of all, I'm not really going to worry about the horn. I guess the thing is, sometimes you guys go, why don't you do the horn? Why don't you do the engine? When the things aren't related to the video, this is like a visual thing. I want to show the visual thing. So people are like, you didn't do the engine. You're such a ricer, Lex, whatever. It doesn't matter. We're not driving this about. We're just doing a cool modifying, tuning it up, making it look nice thing. So we're not going to worry about the horn. We're not going to worry about armor. We're not really even going to worry about brakes, exactly. Let's just go to front bumper, because there are so many. 14 different front bumpers. This is awesome. This is awesome. So we have the custom splitter. Oh, that's nice. I like that. We have the classic RS bumper. I like that too. Sticker bump. Oh, okay. Well, in that case, the names. By the way, this replaces the Sultan RS. You might notice that it even had the muscle sound. It changes a lot of files for this thing to get it to work. It's okay. So those names we can completely ignore. So we have this one with some lights behind the grill. Oh my god. Oh wow. Okay, is there going to be like a police car livery or something? Because this looks like it could be an amazing police car. So we have this. Oh, even that with like a splitter on it as well and a tow hook. Then we get rid of that splitter and tow hook. This one with some canards on it as well. What is the name for those things that sort of hold the splitter there? Do they have a name? Or are they just like splitter holder thingies? I don't know. And then we have this one, which actually extends the front end. And that makes it look really nice. Now, I should say that sometimes when I modify these things, these are like well-known kits perhaps to some people. I don't know much about American cars. I really don't know much about the Dodge Challenger. I like how it looks. I like everything else, but I don't really pay attention to it. So I don't know if this is like a famous kit or this is part of a... I don't know. It looks sort of Trans Am-y, that sort of front end with the little like tip in the middle, little point. I don't know. I don't know if that's from anything in particular. Then we have this one. It's actually got some little I just noticed the lights. Those ones have sort of evil eye things on them. Not really a fan of those. Continuing down, we have this one, which looks pretty nice. And then a full carbon front end. Really don't like... That looks like a Carbra. Like a carbon Carbra or something. No, I don't really like that one at all. And then another version. No, I don't really like that either. So let's go back. I quite like this one, but I don't really like what's happening with the lights there. So I like this one as well, but I don't like that huge front splitter. But I like the extended front end. But I do like these bull bars. Do you know what? I think I'm... Depending how long this takes, because I think this might take quite a long time to modify one car. I'm wondering if maybe I should do two, because I really want to try out all the bull bars and stuff, because I think we can make a proper, like a battle car style Challenger. But I also think that we'd want to try something else as well. So I'm going to start, first of all, by making a proper battle car Challenger. And I think I'm going to go at this point without the splitter on the bottom. So we're going to go for that one. Now onto the rear, not as many options as the front, but that should be okay. Let's see what we got here. So we got this one, which I'm not really feeling. I'm not really feeling how that looks, to be quite honest with you. Then we have another version in... Is that carbon fiber or is that just black? I think that's just black and white. Then we have this one, which is a full carbon rear bumper. I'm not really sure... Do people do that? Is this a thing in real life or is this just something that the mod makers... I don't know if I've ever seen a car that has like the whole bumper like that in carbon fiber. I don't know. Then we have this one. We have two different... Oh, they're the same. Oh, we have two different color things. Ah, here we go. Now we have the bull bars. And then the bull bars with the thing. No, I don't like how that looks. I'm just going to go for the standard bull bar thing with the standard bumper. I think that looks pretty meaty and amazing. I'm really into battle cars at the moment. So this is really... This is why I'm going for it. I really want a car that just looks so mean and like it can go off-roading and... I don't know. It's a mix between me watching loads of roadkill and me also looking through the battle cars subreddit. There's some amazing stuff in there. So on the exhausts we have these ones. I just noticed that actually that's just a fake exhaust thing, but the real exhaust is in the middle. Can we change that? Okay. So we have this one, which is a nice little upswept DTM style one, or a much larger DTM style one. Then we have these ones, which look like bike exhausts sticking out the side. Really think they look horrible. Then we have this one, just one nice exhaust on one side. And then we have, yeah, I like that one. I like that one. And yeah, I don't like that sort of trumpet thing. I quite like how that looks. That looks like a sort of tuned up version of the standard car. So I'm going to go for that one. On the fenders, we have secondary color arches. Okay, so we must have same primary and secondary at this point. It's always blue. Then we have the carbon arches. I really don't like how all this carbon looks, really. Then we have the primary color bolt-on arches. How does that compare? Are they just bigger? They're the same. Oh, they're the same. They've just got little bolts on them. Okay. Then we have primary, secondary color. Then we have carbon. And then we have... actually, the names in this one do actually line up. Wide body arch extensions. Oh, okay. That's actually just a matte black version of that then. Okay. Should we go for the bolt-on ones? I'm not sure, actually. I quite like it without all these silly arches. I quite like how it looks standard, to be honest. I think these arches just look way too big and silly. So I'm going to go with the standard in this one. I know this is kind of against... normally, I would just go and add everything. But a lot of you complain that I stick on things that you don't really need. So in this case, I'm actually going to build something I truly like. Although I'm probably still going to get insulted and called a rice or whatever. Fuck everyone. Skirts, we have black rubber mud flaps. Then we have primary color mud flaps, secondary color mud flaps, actually. Oh, of course, the primary and secondary is the same right now. And side skirt extensions. Ooh, okay. It's different. I don't really know what the use is for that thing, but it looks very battle car inspired. So, of course, I'm going to go for that one. On the roll cage on the inside, we've got this street half cage. Then we've got a dash dodger cage, which looks like the same one just painted. Is that the same? It looks pretty much the same. Then we have the padded one. Actually, that's not padded at all. I can't see where the difference lies between these two. Okay, so of course, I keep forgetting that some of these names aren't going to match up, are they? Then we have this one, which doesn't seem to be padded either. That just seems to be a sort of chrome cage. Slightly different. Oh, that one has got some padding on it. I could see some padding on that one. And then another one here. Again, has that got padding on it? I could barely see inside. Oh, I can see some padding. I can see some padding. I think I'm going to go for the full rear cage. I think that one looks the nicest. Onto the grill now then. Remove grill. Okay. Then we have intercooler. I quite like the standard grow in this one compared to these other ones. Then we have ones with water spray. Oh, of course, they're not the... I should stop reading the names, which I haven't learned yet. I haven't learned this. Okay, so we have this SRT grill. We have this grill, which I don't really like. The non-grill, not really much of a fan. Then we have the RT grill, which is the standard one. And then we have this one with an intercooler and sprayer. Yeah, I don't like how that looks. I quite like the SRT one, so I'm going to go for the SRT grill. I think that's quite nice and subtle. On the hood, we have 11 different options. So we have the normal one, which is actually a really nice looking bonnet. Then we have this one, which I don't like the carbon fiber in the middle. In fact, that's not even carbon fiber. This is matte black. Don't like it. That one looks all right. That's just a carbon fiber version of the original. I quite like how that one looks. We have this one. Actually, that's nice as well. I quite like that. Not really too sure about those ones on the top, but they look useful. They look like they have a use of some kind. Oh, wow. Okay, okay. Right, okay, let's just quickly look through all the other ones. So we have this one. Yeah, there's that one. There's that one we can see inside. You can see that one, a carbon version. Another one of those. Very similar to one of the other ones up there. That one. What's the difference? Oh, that one had bonnet nipple things to bonnet things to hold it shut. This one doesn't. Then we have this one and that one with the glass. We've just got to go for this. Look at that. Look at that with those turbos sticking out there. That looks incredible. Oh my god. Yes. Yes. 100 times yes. Right, let's go to roof. We have roof spoiler. Not really a fan. Not really a fan of that. Then we have the vortex generators again. Yeah, I think they would look good in some circumstances, but the current battle car we're building, I'm not sure that works. Then we have the carbon roof. Then we have the carbon roof with spoiler and the vortex generators. And then this, which would look so much better if that roof wasn't in... Is that carbon fiber still? I don't, no, that isn't carbon fiber, but that's just black. I really wish that wasn't black so we could have changed that. Maybe a secondary color thing, but yeah, that looks proper battle car, so we're going to go for that one. On the spoilers, we have a mid-level spoiler. Again, I should probably stop reading the freaking names, but I think these might... Okay. Actually, yeah, the names don't match. Look at that. Wow. Okay. I've got to admit, guys, I really don't have an eye for spoilers. Sometimes I think, oh, that spoiler looks silly. And I look at a car in real life and I think, do you know, if I was in a game and that spoiler came up, I'd go, no, that looks shit. But then I look at that car in real life and I think, do you know, that looks quite nice. So, yeah, I don't have an eye when it comes to spoilers in modifying cars, but I do love duckbill spoilers like this. I might actually go for that one. Then we have a miniature SRT one. I quite like that. That looks like a sort of standard rubberized little rubber duckbill thing. I quite like that one. Then we have another one that's a much higher one than before. Wow, that's really high. I love that one. I love spoilers like that, especially when they continue with the body line like this one has. Actually, that's just added its own body line off the other body line off the side. Now, that looks really nice, I think. I think that works really well. Then we have this one. Then we have this one. Again, I quite like those, but I don't really like the stand underneath, personally. Then we have this one. This one, which... No, that... Okay, that one, to me, looks incredibly wrong. The whole shape, design of that, it doesn't look right. Then we have this one getting even bigger still. And then we have this one. I want it to get bigger. There must be something bigger. I don't think we've seen biggest yet. Then we have this one. This is a very drag style one. I quite like that. I quite like how that one looks. It would be nice if it was sticking out the back just a little bit more. Then we have this one. This one, which is very Plymouth. Oh, what is that? The Roadrunner Plymouth. That is a... Yeah, I think that's very Plymouth Roadrunner inspired. I quite like that one as well. Although it doesn't really fit in with this car that well, in my opinion. And then... Oh my god. Hang on. That's not even attached. I don't think that's supposed to be there. That looks like the Atomic Attack wing that's actually supposed to be stuck to the Sultan, because that's not even attached to the bonnet, or the boot, rather. Yeah, okay. So I think, for the sake of this one, I think we're going to go for a nice little duck bill. I love how that looks. I like how this one looks. I think we're going to go for this one. I think that looks amazing. Let's just go for that one. I'm not sure it completely fits in with the whole, road... rally, it's not road rally, the whole like road evil, I've forgotten, the battle cars, that's it, the battle cars. It's not really battle car-ish, maybe, I don't know, but I like how it looks, so we're just gonna go for it. On transmission, doesn't really matter, we're not gonna be driving it about all that too much, for the sake of this video, because it's, again, it's a visual thing. Door speakers. This is going completely against. Hopefully, there's going to be some more stuff than just door speakers. Let's have a look. So we have this one. So this goes from the red interior to a cream, but still has the red on the inside. Not sure how those are going to correlate together. Then we have some black door cards. I quite like how those look. Then we have a more racing-inspired one. I like this. That's just a basic cutout thing that's been riveted on. Possibly carbon fiber. I can't really see from this angle. Then we have... what's that? Is that carbon fiber? Oh, no, that one is carbon fiber. I can see the carbon fiber now. That one is just whatever. I can't really see on the inside. It would be nice if we had a small view. I think that's supposed to be just... I don't know. That looks like a super lightweight one as well. And then we have the door speakers as well, which for some reason the reflections have neons and the real things don't. Kind of weird. And then, okay, now it just gets mental. So there are actually many different combinations that we can have here, because we have the racing, we have the sort of fancy, and then we have the all-out crazy proper base car style thing. I'm going to go for this one right here, the non-carbon fiber version. Let's go to seats then. We have sports seats. It would be nice if we could look from the inside or just a little bit closer in. Then we have these ones, which would match those door cards. Then we have these ones, full seats, pretty nice looking. And then we're moving on to some better sports seats now. Then we got onto some Recaros in different colors, green, red, blue, brides, nice big brides. I wonder what they're like to actually sit in. I've never sat in a proper fixed bucket seat like that, but they do look a bit uncomfortable to me. So then we also have the black bride, an orange bride, and then we have a single Recaro, which is pretty cool. Not sure how your passenger's going to... I imagine that you'd still be allowed a passenger in this despite the fact there's only one seat there. Then we have that in green. Then we have... oh, I quite like this one. The ballistic fiber one. The ballistic fiber bride seat. And then the... what's that down there? That's another ballistic fiber... what is that pattern? What is that? That looks like giant snakeskin or something. That's a really small thing. And that's actually back to the start again. So I think I might go for... is there just a black... there's a black bride? But I only wanted the one seat, so I think I'll go with this one then. The Black Bride, one seat, with the Kevlar on the back. I think we'll go for that one. On the speakers in the boot, oh wow, okay, that's a strange texture that's really sort of going weird. We have this, then we have this, then we have this, and this. This one with the neons and the, yeah, I'm not sure these really fit in with the style of the car exactly. So I don't think we're going to include them on this one. I mean, maybe you could have, like, some small speakers like that and still have that working. So, I guess we'll go for this one. It looks a darn sight nicer than that one as well. So, let's go for that one then. Hydraulics. We can also add hydraulics things in, which, again, don't really fit in with this car exactly, considering it's supposed to be a battle car. So, we'll not worry about any of those. Arch covers, which actually isn't arch covers at all. So, we have custom eyebrows on the lights. Don't like those whatsoever. Then we have these, the sort of things to stop the glass shattering everywhere. I quite like those. Rallying spot. Wow. Okay. That's nice. I like that. Although we have actually changed the grill already and now we're sort of like reversing that by just putting this on. But that looks awesome. That looks really nice. But I'm not sure if it goes with the rest of this look. I'm not really sure that works. So then we have this one. Those are all the same. Those are all- is it changing something else? No, no, nothing else is changing. Okay, so those last three don't actually do anything. I'm going to go for these ones, as that goes with the whole look of the battle car. On window decorations, we have painted wind deflectors. Okay, carbon wind deflectors or, oh, okay, a window safety net. Now this is turning into a proper off-roading battle car rally car. That's amazing. Right, let's go for those then. On the livery, we have a nice selection here. We got black classics. Okay, the names don't work. Okay, let's ignore the names. So we have this one, which again, we'd definitely have to change all the colors to get that to match. Then we have this one, which not a fan. This one, they're not too bad. They're not too bad colors, not too bad designs. So then we have a nice camouflage one here. Then we have the flames. Looks awful. Oh, I do like a bit of rust and a bit of a ratty look. I don't, however, this might be a bit of a jarring opinion for some of you people. I really don't like Gas Monkey Garage. I'm really not a fan of Richard Rawlings, I have to admit. I just think he's really obnoxious. I think he's, okay. Don't really think much of him. And then, oh, okay. This is actually the same sort of... in fact, this is pretty much the same texture as the one that we got in the Slam Van. But it doesn't look as nice here, especially as the arches and stuff don't match. And also, there's like a blue glow, a blue thing on the paint. Can you see that? Or is that just... I think the textures are actually all buggered on the front. I think that's the problem. Then we have this one, which is all the soles and stuff. I think that's from the Slam Van as well. I quite like... Even though I don't like Gas Monkey, I like how the rest of that rust looks. Is there some sort... Okay, there is actually a problem with the textures on the front bumper. As I can see there is a join where it's rusty on this side. Not so rusty on that side. So it is a bit mismatched. And that door isn't rusty either. Whereas the other doors and stuff are. The textures do seem a little bit broken and not uniform. And yeah, I'll go for that one. Okay, it's not perfect, but I'll go for that one. Okay, so moving on to bodywork, and we've got aerials, which is actually not aerials. Oh, okay. Rally fogs, which are actually in the way of the turbos. Nah. Or we have... Oh, my God. Okay, so that's actually an extra. Oh, okay. So we didn't need to get those ball bars because there's a set of ball bars right here. That's actually combining with the other set of ball bars. Yeah. Okay, that is cool. But I don't think that works with the other set of ball bars. So actually, I'm going to go for that one. And I'm just going to go back to the front bumpers right here and see how that changes. So we have... Yeah, see, look, we can now have the full ball bar thing, but without having to get the ball bar thing, as long as it all matches. Yeah, see? See? Although, I just noticed some of the textures... Yeah, some of these don't have the textures of the livery, which is a damn shame. And then we have this one, which I quite like. And then this one with the canards, they don't really work. That one... Wow, okay, with the extended front end and the big massive splitter, but that kind of works. That kind of works, but it doesn't have the livery, which is a shame. Then we have this one that works. Not really much of a fan of those. I wish we had an extended front end that had the liveries on it. So I think we might actually just go with a standard front bumper, I think, because I think the rest of them... What have we got here? We could have that one with a little splitter on the bottom. Yeah, let's go for that one. Let's just go for that one. So now we got rid of that front ball bar and added that one in instead. That's a bit meaner, a bit more crazy, a bit more... battle car style, I would say. Oh, God, I wish I'd stopped doing that. Okay, moving on to engine. We don't really need to worry about the engine upgrade. I don't think it's going to matter visually. No, okay. Engine block, we have... Oh, a nice painted one. Then we have secondary, of course. Carbon fiber. And then the lowrider detail style one. Good dear God. Okay, I might go with the blue, as I quite like having covers matching with the bodywork. That's quite a nice feature. Air filters. Oh, okay. So we can have that one, that one, that one, which actually matches with the livery, which is cool, though that texture seems a bit broken. Oh, here we go. Oh, look at this. Look, this is just ridiculous now. This is just going beyond what is expected. So we have that one. Oh, there's some smaller air filters there. They look quite nice. Yeah, they quite look. They look nice. But look at that. A full-blown engine with those big, massive turbos. I mean, taking that off-road would be a massive mistake. Yeah, that would be bad news. All the sand and stuff going into those turbos. But look at that. That does look amazing. I think that is slightly overkill. Should we make this like a roadkill style? Because roadkill just... They do go overkill. And I think we might go for a roadkill battle car style with that, because that does look amazing. And then we also have the choice of strut braces, which actually go through the block. So that's probably not a good idea. But we have some strut braces. Oh, we have some strut braces that go behind as well. We can have that in a nice chrome. Let's go for a nice chrome on that one then. Interior we'll leave till last. Number plate, number color. Let's just go for black. I love black plates. Let's go to lights. We have headlight options, just stock and xenon. We have neons and color. Not going to worry about those. Window tint. Well, that's going to look weird with the things in the window, so we're not going to worry about that. Turbo, I like a bit of turbo sound, so why not, just for the quick drive. Respray, now hopefully this is not going to be a blue livery, and this is actually going to match up with the colour. So, let's go to, matte, and, oh yeah. And actually, what I've just thought is you can actually have better colour options with the menus mod. There is like a whole worn out, there's like two extra colour sections. So I think we might just go for a random color here, and I'm going to go outside and play with the menus one. So let's just go with the desert tan for now, and we'll worry about that later. What's the secondary color going to change exactly? Let's just see. Classic. Oh, it changes the color of the brake calipers and what else? The roll cage? Okay, that's what it changes. So maybe I'll just keep it black. Let's just go to black. There we go. Anthracite gray. Why not? There we go. And wheels. Now, I want to go for some nice off-roading wheels. They might look slightly smaller than these ones, though. Yep. Yep, they definitely do. They look a hell of a lot smaller. I wish they didn't. I wish they were just a little bit bigger. But that can kind of work. We can have them in chrome. Something like... No, I'm not sure, actually. I really don't like the designs of these off-roading wheels. But I would like to have all these off-roading tires and stuff. Okay. What have we got in muscle car, then? Yeah, we can go for some muscle car. We definitely need to change the color of the wheels unless we go out and look at the chrome versions. These aren't too bad. Should we go for one of these? Maybe something like that. These little Roadstyle-style wheels. Are they Roadstyles? They're kind of close to Roadstyles. They can kind of work. Although, actually, I do... Yeah. I really don't like these standard wheels, but the rest of them... They just look a bit wrong. The fitment's just a bit wrong. The size, the tire size, it's all just not matching. Actually, I quite like these ones, the Dukes. So I'm going to go for the Dukes because I don't think we're going to have a version of those in the off-road section. We do not. Okay, not to worry about that then. That's in chrome. We don't need to worry about that. Tires. We can have some writing on the side. Why not? Why not? And that is everything done. So let's jump out. And also, I'm going to change the color using good old menus mods. Let's go to vehicle options. Let's go to menu customs. Let's stick it out in the sun here so we can see. So if I go to paint, you should see, let's go to paint here, we have primary, we have utility and worn, and it has a bunch of extra colors. Let's look at these. We've got some alloy, gunmetal. We've got some really nice ones. We've also got like police blue. I mean, these are really nice colors. I don't know how this is really police related, but it is a nice color. We've got Maui blue, bright blue, brown, medium brown, loads of different shades, some nice off-white there. And what I want to do is go to worn, as I do have a color in mind, because it was a color I've been playing with recently on another car. It's this one here. It's this red. And the reason for that is it looks like red oxide primer. And I think that is a really cool look. I think everyone normally goes for like matte black primer if they're ever going to like leave their car in primer. Or just like not even bother at all, so it's like either grey or whatever. I think this looks quite nice as like a primer, as like the main coat of paint. With all the rust and stuff, I think it looks really sort of cool and ratty and awesome. So I'm going to go for that. There we go. And also, because this is a lowrider, we should have hydraulics, right? Unless, oh, mind you, I didn't put the hydraulics in. So I guess it wouldn't actually give us the option for hydraulics. Interesting. Let's just see if that works then. Let's just go to lowriders and go to hydraulics. And I'm just going to stick on some pumps. You're not going to be able to see them. But is this going to give us the option to... Oh, okay. So even still, we actually just have the hydraulics thing in there for a visual look. We don't actually have any sort of hydraulics maneuvers at all. So maybe we'll have to try out slam it just to see what it looks like with it nice and slammed down. It's going to slam it. If that wasn't floating away, this is why I wanted the hydraulics. I wanted it to be up to look like it was a jacked up lowrider, a jacked up off-roader, I mean. But yeah, I think these ones, I think tiptoeing is perhaps the best, but it does sort of ruin the speed and its sort of grip on the road because it is lifting the car up rather than lifting the suspension. That's how it works. That's why that the proper slam it, as it notes at the bottom there, you can actually drive on walls with it like that because it really just changes the gravity thing. So yeah, we can have it like that. Would be nice if it wasn't trying to float away, but I think that looks really freaking cool. I don't know if we have... Do we have enough time? I might like rush for a quick one in just a moment, but I want to take this up into the hills so we can really get a good look at this visually, because it does look amazing. And I just thought maybe I could also stick some extra dirt in there. So I'm going to go to paint menu. I'm going to go to dirt level. And let's just make her a little bit dirtier. Why does it look like I'm fully dirty? Yeah, that works. We've got some rust. We've got some dirt. It sort of made the wheels and the tires more dirty and matted. And yeah, look at this. This is amazing. Let's go to... Oh, I forgot the interior. I forgot the interior. I know some of you right now are going, Lex, the interior, no! Okay, right, let's go back. Let's go back and do the interior. I got so damn excited about how this looks that I completely forgot about the interior. And I reckon there's going to be some amazing interior things. So let's just go back in here. Let's go to repair. Although I do quite like how it looks with all the scratches and stuff. That looks amazing. But let's just fix it for now. And, it's still dirty. That's nice. It still kept it dirty for us. That's cool. So let's go down to the interior. How could we forget you, interior? Look at that. Look at the detail in this. This looks amazing. So there we go. We can actually see that, yeah, that is actually using the main paint color. So I'm actually going to change that door, as I think it would look better with perhaps the carbon version. Let's just go for that one. I think, oh God, I didn't mean to jump out. I'm really starting to mess up now. That threw me off. That was a good thing I remembered, because otherwise you guys would have grilled me in the comments. Right, okay, so now, yeah, that works. All nice and carbon fiber, that's cool. So let's see what we can really do with this interior. So let's go to trim, design. We have a sun strip, which, let's not worry about that. Color for the trim? Is this really, I can't see any changes at all. That's not changing anything whatsoever. Maybe that changed the color of the sun strip. Let's see. No. Okay, don't know what that's about. Dials, we have pod-mounted taco. Oh, okay. Interesting. Then we have a cluster-mounted taco. Then we have this one with the ones in the glove box. Then we have this one, which sort of gives us a fuse box in the middle. Because fuse box, race car reasons. Don't know why. Would you really need that fuse box thing there? Is that right or... I don't know. That doesn't look right. Especially as it's sort of... That must have been something for the Sultan, because I don't know why... It doesn't even fit in with the grill of the fans there. It looks a bit odd. And then we have this one with some extra piled taco things everywhere. And then we have this one, which is a combination of them. I kind of like how it looks for the rawness factor, but I don't really understand why it's there. So I think we'll go for this one, but we really need to change the color of this light because it looks awful. Although, oh, we can't even change it. What? What? No. 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 Okay. Right, let's just look for dashboard first. Let's get rid of all these dials first and see how the dashboard looks. So we have steering wheels. We'd do that after the dashboard. So we have the street interior. Oh, okay. Okay, things are starting to change. We've got this really awesome gear stick. We've got the dials are changing. They're changing the color. They're changing the middle bit. We've got some little rocker switches. We've got like all the carpets ripped out. Oh, yeah. We're starting to notice some change. This is just the street interior. How does this progress? We've also got this netting here, which is really cool. Then we have the semi-stripped interior, which gets rid of... Oh, it changes that from the wood grain to that. It changes the... Why does that go to black? Why would we want a red fire extinguisher? Then we have that, which also changes the rocker switches to a non-red and also gets rid of the nice color. It gives us green dials, which actually I'm not really a fan of. I quite like those ones. Then we have this one, which is pretty much the same, just another combination. How does that differ from this one? Those two look the same. They look very much the same. Okay, I don't know. And then this one, which is the same again. Oh, they're all the same. Oh. Okay, well, that's our different options then. I think we should go for... I quite like that one for the black, but I wish it didn't have the green dials, but sod it. Light color isn't going to affect it, is it? No, it's not actually going to do anything, which is a huge shame, because these dials, they're blue. It looks odd in blue. But, for the sake of it, let's just do that. But actually, I'm not really a fan of any of those, to be quite honest with you. Steering wheels we have, I don't think any of these are going to fit on a modern car. Oh, hang on. Oh my God, it actually has custom steering wheels. Okay, so we have the SRT steering wheel. Then we have one in... Oh, this is cool. This is cool. And then we've got a Gas Monkey Garage one. Gas Monkey. Wow. Oh, wow. Okay, so we have this with the yellow on the top, red on the top. Then we have a gray version. Then we have this one. That doesn't look like it was in GTA either. Oh, my God. These are amazing. These are amazing. Why do more cars not have these custom steering wheels in them? That's fantastic. We've got to go for this in the red. Straight away, that does look absolutely incredible. I guess this is everything done then. Oh yeah, let's just jump out and go back off-roading, because this is just amazing looking. And here we are in the dirt, and what I want to do is just damage it just a wee bit, just get a few scratches and stuff on it, as I think it looks a lot more cooler with some battle scars on this thing. There we go, let's put some scrapes on the side. There we go, a little bit of denting. There we go, how's that looking? Actually, that's not changed too much, really. Does this even have damage? It seems to have like a couple of little scar things. Perhaps we need to go a bit faster here. Up to here. This is one of these roads that is really not well traveled for me. I barely go up here at all. But I do quite like this, especially with the little reservoir thing around here. It is a really nice area. Look at that. That's a really nice area. But this just suits the environment absolutely perfectly. Let's go to interior view so we can see this. Good God. Look at this. Oh, wow. Okay. When we're in the interior... This sounds awesome. Let's just give this a listen. Okay, that sounds amazing. That sounds loads better than being in this view. But look at that. That is a really nice looking Challenger. I'm in love with this. I really like battle cars. This is really what I'm into lately. This damage is not happening like I was expecting. We've got a couple of marks there, but generally this is a pretty sturdy car, I must say. I am in love with this. This is absolutely brilliant. Right, let's make one quick one. I'm not going to spend ages worrying about each thing. I'm just going to sort of quickly go through and make something of a different style. But this one for me, oh God, is an absolute winner. Oh, there we go. There's some more scars. This is absolutely fantastic. I love this. I love this so much. Okay, so let's see how quickly we can actually modify a completely different version of the Charger. So we have, let's just go through these. I want to go for something. It's just so easy to just want to go for the bull bars because they do look amazing. I reckon this one is, I quite like that extended front end on that one. On the rear bumper, let's go for, I mean, these will have those, that has the carbon. So I guess that one might work. Let's go to exhaust, and I don't think the upswept ones are going to work. Maybe these big bore ones. It looks silly, but maybe it's going to work for what I'm thinking. Fenders. Now, let's go for the big fenders that we didn't use before, and I'm going to go for them bolted on. That's the fashion right now, so let's go for that one. Skirts. We'll go for the big mud flaps. What else? Oh, that was the other one, wasn't it? Let's go for the big black rubber mud flaps. Actually, we don't need mud flaps. I'm not going to worry about those, actually. Let's get rid of those. Roll cage. Let's just go for a standard something. Let's go for the one that matches the color. So that one. On the grill, we have these ones. Okay, I might just go with the SRT one again. On the hood, I'm thinking of... God, that looks so cool, doesn't it? I'm thinking maybe this one. Or this one here. I think this one here. Let's go for that one. On the roof, we can go for the vortex generators. I think maybe we won't go for the carbon versions of those. That one looks alright-ish. Actually, I don't really like any of those. Let's go for the vortex generators. On the spoilers, I want big. I want big. I want crazy. What can we get? I mean, that one doesn't fit, does it? So the biggest one that we have is that one right there. That does look incredible. Let's go for that one. I think this is going to be a huge mismatch. I just want to see how quickly we can make something crazy. Let's go for crazy door speakers. This is how mismatched this is going to be. We've taken care. We've made the cool one. Now let's just be silly. Then we can go for... I want to go for a nice gentle interior on this one to really sort of... it's a nice juxtaposition from the craziness on the outside. Let's go for a really mundane looking inside. So we'll go for those nice cream leather seats. Actually, in fact, let's just go to door speakers and get the nice matching. There we go. On speakers. Yeah, whatever. Let's just stick those in. On hydraulics, well, they're not going to fit in anymore, so we're not even going to worry about those. Arch covers, which is these things, isn't it? We can go for those. Let's go for that. Make it as crazy as possible. Window decorations, we can have those like that. Livery. I don't think the liveries are really going to work for this, maybe, although I quite like these. I quite like that. Should we go for this one? The carbon fiber? Not carbon fiber. Should we go for the camouflage one? I think we'll go for the camouflage one. Aerial, which is the rally fogs, which is that one. Let's go for the rally fogs. Trim. Oh, I forgot those. Oh, I didn't. Oh, I missed those out. Okay, well, I'm sure someone in the comments who hasn't watched this far is probably going to have a go at me for that one. Yeah, well, both of them look shit, but I think we're going to go for those ones. Okay. Yeah, I know that they have a use in rally, but I don't know. For most cases, they do look a bit odd. I'm not really a fan. Engines. We can always have a nice engine block there in carbon. And then we'll have... These aren't really going to... How's that going to look if we set that on? Okay, that's just... Oh, okay, it just sticks out the top in the imaginary hole. Okay, well, we won't worry about those. Let's go for a nice chrome air filter. It looks pretty nice. Struts. We can go for a nice big chrome strut. Yeah, that looks cool. Let's go for that one. Interior we'll leave to last or forget about again, however it works out. Window tint, turbo, respray. We haven't got much else. Respray, primary color, classic... What's this going to be changing? It's going to be changing that. So let's just go for a black steel so it matches all the colors. Let's go for... What does it look like if we really change the color here? It kind of works. Kind of... Nah, okay, it doesn't. Okay, let's just not kid ourselves here. Metallic or classic color on the secondary, which isn't really changing much at all. So we'll just ignore it. And then the wheels. And the wheels that are on it kind of fits. I just remember that we still got slam it on, so we can actually make this a lot lower in just a moment. But I think all of these... okay. Yeah, let's just keep what's there. Okay, interior. Before we forget, dashboard. Should we go for the street interior, or shall we? We wanted to make it nice and. Yeah, it's a shame we can't select the. Hang on. Trim, color. Oh, we can't match the freaking receipts. Oh, that's a huge shame. Ugh. Okay, yeah, I think this is probably a lost cause, as I don't think we're ever going to top what we've already got. But that looks nice to get that matching there. Still doesn't have the matching floor. Sod it. Let's just get rid of the unmatching things by just stripping it out slightly. There we go. That works. That sort of works. Well, there we go. There we go. This is our Dodge Challenger, which was hastily put together, but is nowhere near as cool as the previous one. The battle car was just an amazing build. I hope you guys like it. I'm sure there's going to be people who hate it. There always is. It's really, and people don't just hate car things. They hate you for making that car. This is how serious people are in the car scene, and it is sad, really. It's really just lighten up. Enjoy the fact that it's a game and we're making something fun. It doesn't have to be super serious. You don't have to own the car. It doesn't have to be like you'd own it in real life. It's just a bit of fun. So there we go. This is the crazy silly one, but I definitely much prefer the first one. But there we go, guys. That is it. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know. This is an incredibly long video. I could only apologize, or maybe that's what you guys want. I don't know. Let me know. So there we go, guys. Thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you. Hang on. We haven't done this in a while. If you have genuinely got to the end of this video, as in you have watched through the entire video, I want you to say, oh God, what's the secret word going to be? Dump truck. Dump truck. Is that dump truck down there? Are they going to shoot me? Nope, they're just going to try and run at me. Yeah, the secret word is going to be dump truck for this video if you have genuinely watched through the entire video. So there we go, guys. Maybe I'll start bringing back the secret word of the day. I don't know. There we go. I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.